Hello and welcome to the channel that the Lord by His grace and mercy allowed me to make to bring honor and glory to His name, my dear friends, and the way that the Lord would use me to bring honor and glory and praise to His holy, precious name would be to help Him to receive, as the Bible says, the reward of His suffering. Souls of men to come into the kingdom of God, to be swept in to heaven before the great and terrible day of the Lord. My friend, if you're watching my channel, I welcome you and I ask you to please subscribe if you feel led to. I'm a Bible-believing child of the Most High God. I believe that for, and I've made videos about it, if you want to use the Bible, the best translation in English is the King James Version of the Bible. Why do I say that? I invite you to watch a documentary called Tares Among Wheat. And you will see that the modern translations, though they're good translations, they're using a different text. Some new texts that were found in the 1800s under the guidance and financial support of the Jesuits. So this new these new allegedly ancient translations were brought in. And therefore, modern scholars who try to do good versions of the Bible, like the English Standard Version, they are using the proper text that were used to write the King James, to translate the King James Bible, plus these additional texts, which are of a questionable origin, brothers and sisters and friends. That's why the King James is the Bible we can rely on to be translated out of the original language and tongues, as it says, out of the original text. And the best text that's been passed down over thousands of years. So, therefore, native English speakers should always rely on the King James Bible as the final say-so in which Bible they use. Number two, I'm a Spirit-filled Christian. I came from Assemblies of God. I believe in the gifts of the Spirit are for the church age. They did not cease with the apostles. Most of the ministry work the Lord uses me in is usually in your Baptist churches to bring revival, to bring the Spirit of God to bear with proper evangelism that most Baptist churches do. They are some of the last churches who are focused on what the Lord wants us focused on, which is evangelism. And then the Lord would use me to bring those who are rooted and grounded in the Word, to bring them into the spiritual side of things. And then when the Lord would use me with Spirit-filled churches, Spirit-filled people, to remind them that we must be rooted and grounded in the Word. And therefore, this channel is on YouTube by the grace of God to bring a balance between the Spirit and the Word, that all things would be proven by two or more witnesses from the Word. All things that God would tell us, we say we heard from God by word of wisdom, word of knowledge, all these kind of things, that it would be testified to by two or more witnesses from the Word of God. And then lastly, brothers and sisters, the Lord called me and even gave me a book to write, and the title of the book is Final Boarding Call. So this is my challenge for the final boarding call before the tribulation begins, for those who would be in the bride, to be raptured, to be caught up to meet the Lord in the air. As 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 16, 17, and 18 says, "For the Lord Himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first, and those of us who are alive and remain shall be caught up together to meet the Lord in the air. Therefore, shall we always be with the Lord." So therefore, we must be prepared to meet the Lord at all times. And He will come in a moment. It says in 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 51 and 52, "There will be change in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye. The Lord will come for us in the twinkling of an eye." He said He would come as a thief in the night. Even as Paul also tells us in 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, that the Lord would come as a thief in the night. And He said He would come at an hour that the world does not expect. Those who are sleeping would not expect. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5 says that we are not those of the darkness, but of the light, so that day would not overtake us as a thief. Therefore, we would be prepared, even though we don't know the day or the hour. No one knows the day or the hour. But we would be prepared to meet the Lord in the air. Therefore, the Lord commissioned me to make an online virtual church called Church of the Firstborn from Hebrews chapter 12. That the church of the firstborn is, and that text from Hebrews 12, we see the church in heaven with the Lord, with the Father, with the holy angels, with those saints who's gone on before us, and us, the bride of Christ, there with the Lord at the church of the firstborn. And therefore, the Lord has commissioned me to prepare his bride as a prophet of God, to call his people. If my people, God said, 2 Chronicles chapter 7, verse 14, King Solomon said as he dedicated the temple, speaking by the Spirit of God, if my people who are called by my name would humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways. We Christians need to turn from our wicked ways and obey those instructions. That God would hear from heaven. He would forgive us of our sins and heal our land. And brothers and sisters, we need in this last day our land, our family, our home. Even if the United States and Canada, wherever you live, is going to hell in a handbasket, it's nothing to do with you and your house and your land. The land that you have authority in, your own family, your own household. As Joshua said, I don't know what you guys are going to do, but as for me and my family, we will serve the Lord. So that's the call. Serve the Lord. Serve the Lord today. Serve the Lord every day. Serve the Lord tomorrow. Serve, serve, serve the Lord. As Jesus said in Luke, take up your cross daily and follow me. Those who will not take up their cross daily and follow me is not worthy of me. He who puts his hand to the plow and turns back is not worthy of me. May you be found worthy, as Jesus said in Luke 21, 36. He gave us a commandment as he spoke about the end times. Luke 17, Luke 21, Matthew 24, Mark 13, all these texts talk about the last days, tribulation period. And Jesus said after he talked about that tribulation in Luke 21, in verse 36, he said to us, watch. Look up. Therefore, always, always, and pray that you be counted worthy to escape these things and stand before the Son of Man. He didn't say one prayer, say a sinner's prayer, and hey, you're good to go. He said, watch always and pray always that you be counted worthy to escape these things and stand before the Son of Man. You should pray always and faint not, but rely on the grace of God by faith through grace are we saved. Praise God. My doctrine is basically the standard of what you would hear in Assemblies of God Church or Church of God Church. If you know about their doctrine, you can look it up. The cardinal doctrines of Assemblies of God, as far as I know, I basically agree with everything they do. Just FYI for your information, if you're interested to know where I stand and what I believe, brothers and sisters. Basically, as you look up the cardinal doctrines and the doctrines of Assemblies of God, I basically agree with all of them as far as I know. There's nothing in there that I do not accept as truth. God bless you guys. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May his face shine upon you. May he lift up your countenance and give you peace. That's for number 6. And I misquoted it a little bit. I got it backwards there. But praise God. Right now, brothers and sisters, I praise God Almighty and I release and speak the blessings of the Most High God. Hallelujah. And the Word of God says in Revelation, he who is thirsty, let him come and drink freely of the river of living water that flows from the throne of the Lord. Hallelujah. Come and drink and be filled with rivers of living water. Hallelujah. Right now I just speak and release and declare that by the Spirit of God that my channel is releasing a channel of a river of living water. Hallelujah. Get in the river. Hallelujah. Get in the river and be filled with the life of God. Let the Spirit of God change you, not just in your mind, but you have a mental agreement that the gospel is true and that, yeah, you believe that healing's for today and all this, it's all up here. You know, it's like eating bread with no water. You know, let the Spirit, that water of life, the rivers of living water, let that wellspring of God just run down into you from here, from your mind, and wash that Word of God down into your heart, that it be quickened in your spirit. Quickened in your mortal body, that your spirit will be resurrected. Hallelujah. In a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, let your spirit be resurrected in the mighty things of God. God bless you guys. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you as you go forward in your walk with our Lord and Savior, Yahshua HaMashiach. That's Hebrew for Jesus the Messiah, Jesus the Christ, the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. Hallelujah. May we, like John chapter 1, behold his glory as the only begotten of the Father. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Whose mercy endures forever. Hallelujah. To our God and King, for his love endureth forever. Praise be God, through whom all blessings flow. Praise God, all ye creatures here below. Praise God, Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Blessings from the Most High God be upon you. in the name of Jesus Christ.